Okay, so now that we have our lighting ready, what we can do is to start working on the interactions. So I'm going to create a couple of buttons here using the cylinder tool. So just click and drag here. So this is my cylinder one, and let's make it smaller. Let's also change the corner to be maybe something like this. Let's go to the front view and let's position this maybe somewhere around here. And then from the top point of view, we can move this object to be somewhere around here. Let's press Command D so we can have two buttons. And let's call this a button one, and this is gonna be button two. So button one is gonna be using the walls material, and button two perhaps is gonna be maybe something like the drawing material. So yeah, we have only two buttons for now. I think maybe actually we can make these buttons a little smaller, maybe something like this, so they, and maybe a little more space out here. All right, so what we want is that when we touch the pink button, these three walls, they will change to pink. So let's see how we can do something like that. So let's just select this object, and now let's create an event. It's gonna be a mouse down event. And then what we can do is let's start by only one wall for now. Let's just create a new state. And what we need to do is that we need to detach these so we can have like an animation in the material. So in this case, this will be maybe using a pink color. So it's gonna be something like this, I think. Can obviously change the colors later, but for now I just want to be using this very simple color. Let's copy this color because we're going to be needing it later. So let's go to this one and says let's create a state here as well. Let's detach, and in this space, and then for this one as well, new state, detach, and then paste this one here. So this is how it looks with the pink color, which is actually quite nice. And for this one, actually, we also want this color to be here because I think this is more closely to what we are seeing, maybe a little darker in this case, something like this. All right, so now from here, from this object, we go to the event, and let's select here the rectangle. Those are the walls, right? So let's just select the rectangle one, which is the wall here. Let's so let's just rename the walls to be more clear. So this is gonna be wall one, this is gonna be wall two, and this is gonna be wall three. And now let's select this object here, and then this is gonna be pointing to wall one. And now I'm going to make this change to the state. So it's gonna be just like that. And then let's add another object. It's going to be wall two, it's going to be to a state two, and then another object here, it's going to be wall three, it's going to be to this state. All right, so now when we go to play mode and we click here on the pink button, it's turning colors, which is pretty nice. But it's a little slow, so we need to do it faster. So let's maybe change this to be maybe more like 0.4, and this 0.4, and this 0.4. Another thing that we need to do is that we want to go to the opposite. So when we click this object, this returns to the previous color. So what we can do now is that we can add an event here. It's gonna be, again, mouse down event, and it's gonna be L1. Going to be 0.4, it's going to be returning to base state, so this is fine. And then wall 2, base state 0.4, and then wall 3, base state 0.4. So now if we play this experience and you click here, it's working fine, and it's working fine here. So now we have a color switcher. How cool is that? So another thing that you can do is that you can change the color of the background, but in order to do that, we need to use a different trick. So let me explain how that works. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a cube here. It's gonna be a really big cube. And just gonna place it there, and it's gonna be in the middle. So I'm going to reset all, so making sure it's all zero here. And I'm going to inverse the size, so it's gonna be rendering from the back. So we're going to be seeing the cube like this, right? And let's make it really, really big. It's gonna be a very huge cube. I'm also going to call it here background, and I'm going to change, going to lock his right now. One thing I want to do is I want to copy this color because I want to assign that color to the cube. So it's gonna be putting it here, and then I'm going to disable this lighting. Right, so now the cube is using this color instead. So I'm going to create another state for this cube, and in this other state, I want it to be maybe a little more pink instead of the color that we have right now. So maybe something like this could work. Yeah, maybe something like that could work. So let's see, we go from here to here, and what we can do now is that in the bottom two, we can add another object here, which is gonna be the background object. And it's gonna switch to this color, and it's also gonna be 0.4. And for the button one color, we do the same. We add the background, and then it's gonna be, in this case, the base state. So it's gonna be returning, and then it's gonna be 0.4. And now when we play this animation here, right? So if I click here, you can see that the color is changing in the background. It's very subtle because it's a pastel color, but it is changing. Yeah, and that's it. That's how can you create these type of experiences. You can obviously go into more details and add more objects here and there, but in general, this is just like a template for you to build something of your own style. All right, so one final step is to adjust our properties in the export panel. So if you go to the export panel, what I would like to do here is I want the public experience to have the panning disabled. And I also want the orbit in touch or mobile devices to only use one touch. And so the panning will be disabled as well. So we will also enable compression and performance mode because we want this to load as fast as possible. And we will also disable the page scroll so there is no conflict in mobile devices when you are trying to scroll and rotate at the same time. So finally, what we want is that we want to enable some orbit limits, the settings, and it's gonna be up 45 degrees. I think that's pretty much fine. But in the bottom, I think it's gonna be maybe something like just zero. For left and right, it's gonna be maybe something like 30 degrees. So let's now see how this works. So you can see there, the limits are constraining it properly. And now if you choose go here and update and then copy the URL, you can paste this on your browser, and you can also copy this embed code and paste this on Webflow or any other web builder, even on something like Notion as well. And if you are working in a code environment, you can also try some of the new code export features. All right, hope you like this tutorial. Bye bye.